taking you out of it, God. Completely healing, God. We take authority over every attack of the enemy that come to hinder this mighty woman of God. Father God, we declare and decree that she's healed right now, God. Father God, there's more running for her, more running for the kingdom. Father God, that the gift that lay dormant within her, we're calling them forth, God. Jesus, we thank you, God, that nothing is too hard for you, God. Nothing is too hard. We take authority of our pain today, God, and soreness right now. We cause it to fall to the ground and be of no profit. We declare complete restoration, God. We thank you that your word declares that the loving you wish above all things that we prosper, be in health, even as our soul is prospering. We declare and decree on this fitness Sunday that is already done. We have the God count of faith that we are calling those things that be not as though they were. We declare and decree that pain has to cease, soreness has to cease. We declare and decree that it's going to take place now. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, God.
Lord, you shall live and not die. Yes.
And I got to make it.
Yeah.
You're going to
make it.
You're going to make it. Come on and let's bless God in his house. Come on and
Sunday. And this is Health and Wellness Sunday. But he said in 3 John verse 2, God, he said, I'm beloved, I wish above all things that I may prosper and be in health, even as your soul prosper. He said, he's a healer today. He's a deliverer. He's a restorer. He said, there is nothing too hard for God. He said, just go to Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. He said, I would change the atmosphere. He said, when you just trust in the Lord with all thy heart, lean out into thy own understanding, in all thy ways, if you acknowledge me, allow me to direct your path. He said, you just have to give it to me from Isaiah 65 and 24. He said, Trisha, before I even called you this morning, you have already answered on her behalf. And while you're yet speaking, you heard her prayer. We thank you from Timothy, he said, that the affection of our prayers, are fired up and heated. The affection of our prayers of a righteous man avails much. And we believe that we receive. He said in Mark, we have mustard seed faith. That we can speak to the ailments. We can speak to that mountain of pain. That mountain of atrophy that's trying to keep her from using her hand up or clapping her hand up, waving her hand. We're speaking to it. And we tell it, be thou removed and cast into the sea. And if we doubt not, we can have whatsoever we say. We declare that the power of death and life is in the tongue. We thank you, God, on this gift this Sunday. And we're walking in Hebrews 11 and 1. We're walking in the now, right now. Our faith is in the now. Your faith is in the now because now faith is the substance of things hoped for. And he gives some evidence. You have some evidence of those things not seen. Glory to your name. He's the evidence. And Hebrews 11 and 6, he said, but without faith, it's impossible to please God. And he that cometh to God must do something. That you must believe that he is. And that he is a rewarder. Do you believe he's a rewarder? Have you been seeking him? He's a rewarder of those that diligently, persistently, consistently seek him. Matthew 6 and 33 says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and all healing is all, strength is all, deliverance is all, and all these things are being added unto you. We thank you, God, that Numbers 23 and 19 says that you're not a man that you should lie. Neither the son of man that you should repent. If he said it, he'll do it. If he spoke it, we know that he'll make it good. And God said that healing is the children's bread. Glory to your name, God. Yes, God. We thank you, God, and we bless the Lord, our soul, and all that is within us. We bless your most holy and righteous name. And if we had 10,000 tongues today, we couldn't praise you enough. He said, let everything that have breath praise ye the Lord. Everything. Everything. He said it was good. It was good. It didn't feel good, but he said it was good. It didn't feel good, but I couldn't even know, but he said it was good that I was afflicted, that I may walk in your status. Romans 8 and 28 says, all of these things, all of what's going on in your life, in every area, he said, all of these things are working together for the good of those who are called according to something. His purpose.
Yes, God.
Glory to you.
Thank you for your purpose, oh God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God, that we have purpose.
You see, we just say, God. See, because in Philippians 4:13, he said that you can do all things.
Yes, yes.
All things through Christ that strengthen you. And he's strengthening you right now. And Philippians 1 and 6 says, he wants you to be confident in this very thing. That he who has begun, he has begun a good work in you. And he's saying, he's going to perfect it. He's going to complete it until the day of Jesus Christ.
It is so.
And Hebrews 11, he said, 19 and 25 is not to begin to assemble yourselves together. He said, because in this house is safe thing. He said, in this place, he said, I have preordained this place called my heart to you, Healing and Deliverance Community Church. He said, this is the vision. He said, because this is the place that we are founded on love. And your life is going to be transformed through the healing and the deliverance power of Jesus Christ.
Thank you for your love.
He said in Romans 12 and 2, he said, I want you to know, I don't want you to conform any longer to the patterns of this world, but I want you to be transformed, trained by the renewing of your mind that you may prove.
Yes, God. Yes.
What is that? Good? What is that? Acceptable?
Yes, God.
And perfect will.
Thank you, Master. Thank
he said, to tell you, I have dealt every man a measure of faith.
Yes,
he said, but I want you to go from faith to faith,
yes,
to glory to glory.
Oh, God.
And he said, a word of Lord,
thank you,
have I hidden in my heart, Psalms 119:11, that I may not sin against thee. And I want you to start just speaking the word over every situation, every circumstances that come contrary to what God says. The devil is saying, you're a liar. You know, it's not, not calling people Satan, and but there's something that's working within them. You got to realize what's working within them, and you got to tell them, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Everything that been said against you that's contrary to the word, I want you to just say, I've caused those words to fall to the ground and be of no profit. Just tell them, back up, devil. I don't receive that word. I want you to start telling them, back up, devil. I don't receive that word. Don't receive. In this season of your healing, I want you to guard your ear gate, what come out of your mouth gate, and your eye gate, what you see. See, you got to be intentional. Don't allow, I will not allow any corrupt communication to come out of my mouth. I will only see those things that are pleasing to God. And I only will hear the voice of the Lord. And as a stranger voice, I shall not follow.
Devil, you trespass.
Yes.
Lord, we love you, God.
Yes, Lord.
We love you,
Jesus. He's out here with your sister so you can believe.
Yes, God. I allowed you to
take care of your sister.
Yes.
So that she can lay hands on you and so you know that you're healed and you're restored.
Yes, God.
Every day, I want you to start holding your hands up just a little higher. Just a little higher. Because it's already there. Already you just got to have the faith to believe it, to release it. And it's already done.
Deal. Hallelujah. Jesus. Hallelujah,
thank
God.
Because
we don't see what we believe, but we believe what we see.
Thank you, Lord God. Glory to you,
God. And God, we can see the healing, Lord God.
Right now, because when she was singing to step, you had to step aside. Then he said he's working it out.
Yes.
And then when at the end she said, let the power, see what she was saying, the power of the Holy Ghost fall in this house.
Jesus.
And see, when he come, we allow him to shift the atmosphere. It's not about our plan, but it's about God's plan.
Yes. Yeah.
And we're here to do his will. And when healing is needed, that's what we're going to do. Deliverance, because he's already here. He just wants us to have the faith and the confidence to believe that all things are possible. I believe that it's already done.
I know it is.
I believe it.
You believe it?
I believe it.
Glory to God.
See, you got to put it in the atmosphere.
I believe it, God. But I know that there's none like you, God. Oh God, I trust you right now.
Yes, God.
God, I got to use those hands.
Yes.
Thank you.
When I'm lonely,
thank you, Lord.
He's my company.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
That's why I'm grateful,
Lord.
I'm grateful.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm so grateful.
Glory to you,
Jesus. I've got Christ.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
In my life.
Jesus. My God, my God.
That's why I am grateful.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, I'm truly grateful.
Yes, I am, God.
Thank you. God, I'm grateful.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm going to give God some praise.
I'm going to give God some praise in the house. Don't you know what a setup? Glory to God is a setup when you just yield and you surrender the house to Him.
I've got Christ.
It's not about us getting our message together, but the message of Christ.
That's why.
Where He can come in freely with demonstration, with signs and wonder.
Yes, I am.
And He did it so that she may believe. She did it so that the naysayers and the soothsayers may believe. For all of those that are watching, God did it. God is the one who did it. He's an Ephesians 3:20 God. And He's able to do. He's able to do exceedingly, abundantly above all that we may but ask or think. And it's according to this power. And we thank God for the Holy Ghost power. This power that He has given us. He has given us the exousia power, the authoritative power, the power that we can call those things that be not as though they were. He has given us the dunamis power, the dynamite power, the ability power to annihilate everything, destroy everything that's not like Christ. It's in us. It's working in us. And I thank you right now in the name of Jesus for your divine healing.
Yes, God.
And for showing yourself mighty and strong.
Okay.
Mighty and strong. Who would serve a God like that?
My sin.
Who would serve a God like that? That we can call upon Him and He will answer. And He will show Himself mighty. So if there is anyone in the house or anyone that may be listening today, any elements that are going on in your body, I command right now that every organ, every fiber, every molecule, every tissue to work in the perfection that God has designed it to work in. I declare right now that that heart got to regulate and pump the blood. I declare right now that your sugar is regulated. I take authority over migraine headaches in the name of Jesus. I declare and decree that every cancer cell must be eradicated in the name of Jesus. And we're walking confident and saying what the Word of God says. Who reports?
Will you believe?
Will you believe?
Yes.
And I declare that I'm going to believe the report of the Lord. And see, we three, we are sitting here as evidence. See, I wasn't even going to say anything, but see, God healed her. He healed her today. And see, and I received my healing. See, because nobody knew about the chronic pain or what I was going through.
And then I had to have emergency surgery. And went to have surgery. But you know what? I heard a word from Bishop Sam. He said that God told him to call a miracle revival. And it was on that Tuesday, I believe, with June the 2nd. And then that man of God spoke and he said, sow a seed. And he said, within 3 days, that God is going to turn around on your behalf. So within that third day, I had surgery on the 7th, I believe. And then, 1 week later, that I supposed to have gone to the doctor to get the report. But when that Friday, the doctor wasn't there, so I had to go Monday before I went to Game Changer. But let me tell you, when I went to the doctor, and the doctor, he came in, and he said, that we had to remove this, but I want you to know that we didn't find nothing. And he said, I don't need to see you until this time next year. Let me tell you how good God is, that you trust and believe. And no matter, I didn't give in. I didn't have that spirit of fear. I believe when I heard the word of God, that there was miracle, signs, and wonder. When I put seed in the ground, he said, as long as the earth remains, there will be seed time and harvest. I went in and had the surgery, and God allowed me to have the strength to continue on. And when I went to get the report came back that I find nothing.
Hallelujah.
And when we went far, we removed it. He said, I give you evidence that we took it away, and there's nothing left in your body, and that you don't have to come back no more in a year. Let me tell you how good our God is. And he said, he did it so that I may believe. He did it so you may believe. He did it today so that you may believe. He healed. He's a healer. He's a deliverer. He's a restorer. He said, just keep trusting me. And he said, don't be afraid. And Dee Dee, what the Lord is speaking to me about you, Dee Dee. He said, there's so much more he has.
Yes.
And he said, you went through all of this so that you can do what you did today. So that you're going to recognize and see something and you'll be able to lay hands in faith and believe with us that healing is the children bring.
Yes,
see, because any time that there's a blood clot that is supposed to have healed you and took you out, that God caused that thing to harden. And he said, I will reroute the blood so that the blood found another path to get to all of the organs that it needs to. That's nothing but the blood of Jesus. So I want to encourage y'all that from this day forward that y'all get in place and y'all run like never before.
Yes, God.
Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes,
God. Never before.
Oh, Jesus. Nobody could have done it but God.
Nobody could do that but God.
But God. Nobody
but God. Yes,
God. He amazes people. He amazes doctors.
Yes, God.
He amazes medical science.
Oh, yes. Because that don't happen.
When have you heard of that?
Uh-uh.
Nowhere in medical history to hear that.
Yes,
it's possible it took me out.
But God.
But God.
But God. See, God has greatness. But we just have to receive that and know that he had, everything you need is already in you. Your head just, I tell you, that from the Game Changer just blew me away. Your head has got to get in line to what God had already preordained from the foundation of the world before you were even formed in your mother womb. He already knew about you. But your head has got to get into the place that it's going to coincide to what God have already placed within you. It's already there. We just got to have it in our head and believe and don't allow devil in hell to move us off course, to tell us anything different, that we believe the reports of the Lord.
I know you're right.
Glory to the name.
I know you're right. Hallelujah.
Bless God. Bless God.
Yes, God.
Bless you, God.
I know you're right.
We just thank God for this.
They don't know.
They don't know. They don't know.
But I swear
glory to God.
They don't know.
God knows all things.
Yes.
And he knew that we'll be right here on this Fitness Sunday with healing and deliverance and restoration. So now we're going to get into the place and we're going to shift. And y'all can do a couple steps and get Fitness Sunday. So y'all don't want to do steps today. Well, y'all don't have to, because God already came to heal, yes, to deliver, to restore. Yes. Did Maya want to sing today?
Yes,
she did.
You want to sing, Maya?
Yeah.
What do you want to sing? Break every chain. And then y'all can do it to break every chain, and then we'll
what you
know? Okay. Glory. Come on and give God some praise in this house. Come on and glorify God in this house. Hallelujah. Praise God for healing. Praise God for the somebody needs to be talking while we find it.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Yes. We just bless the Lord. We get into a place. And you know, we want all of the gifts that God have in the house so they can be magnified. They can be utilized. That we don't want anyone laying dormant. Because God, he imposed in my spirit that he said, I want you to be prepared. I want you to prepare the house. Because I don't know what God is about to do in my life, but he gave me a directive, and he said, prepare the house, prepare the people in the house.
Amen.
He said, I want you to set the house in order. So when there's a time that I'm not here, that is already is going to continue to flow in the anointing of God, that you're going to hear the voice of others. It's not a Patricia thing. It's a God kind of thing. And so we want everyone to get in position. Yeah. And getting in position, we're going to have our leadership meeting. I forgot to say that during the announcement, every fourth Tuesday. So this is the fourth Tuesday. Okay. So we will have our leadership meeting, and then I'm going to have to follow up with my sister, Pastor Pugh, because it's fifth Sunday, and we were planning to do something, but they lost a church member today. Now, who's singing, My God? Is it Charles Jenkins?
No, that's My God is Awesome.
My God is awesome.
That's that one.
Glory to your name. We're going to find it.
Of course
you
can sing that.
Okay. Come on and just keep praising God and glorifying God in the house. And we know that he's already here. He already showed up. He already came to heal. He already came to deliver. He already set us free. He already came and gave us strength. He already is in the house. So we may just have to do break every chain.
Amen.
Come on, y'all, get in place so that we can break every chain.
Sing,
we want
baby.
All the
sadness to sing. Oh. Sang, sweetheart. Miss Maya. Okay. She knew what she was saying.
Brother Caleb.
Break every chain.
Break every chain.